This is Ambitious Angelo for Woo Cuts TV, and I'm here on the blue carpet tonight at the Water Keepers Alliance. I'm here with Rachel Harris. Welcome to Woo Cuts TV.
Thank you so much for having me.
Tell me, where I see a lot of lights, a lot of cameras, celebs and everything. Where am I tonight, Rachel?
Okay, so you're at Largo at the Coronet. We're here to do our comedy, our annual comedy benefit. It's called Keep It Clean. It's our fifth year.
And well, it's going to be a lot of fun. Clean water and dirty comedy.
The group was started by a blue-collar coalition who coalesced on the Hudson River in 1966. They launched a patrol boat and they began suing polluters. I went to work for them in 1984, and I filed during my time with the Hudson River Polluter over 500 lawsuits against polluters. Our success in cleaning up the Hudson inspired the creation of water keepers all over the world. So we're now, we have 350 licensed water keepers. Each one has a patrol boat. They patrol their local waterway and they litigate against polluters. And we've become kind of a people's coast guard of the planet.
We started supporting Water Keeper Alliance in the very, very beginning, not only financially, but help them in every endeavor you could possibly imagine. And when the waterways go, the planet, okay, the population goes, it all goes. And the best thing about Water Keeper that I want to let the world know about is we support what it costs us to operate the organization, all of us, all the people that contribute money. But more important, all the money they win in lawsuits, the organization doesn't take. It all stays locally to buy boats, buy people, give them salaries, to make sure those waterways that we cleaned up stay cleaned up. And then
I've been a part of Water Keepers, I think, for almost 10 years now. And it's amazing to me that people cannot figure out how important water is and clean water is. It is something every person uses and needs every single day. The fact that we have to do this to bring attention to it is really sad. Like, come on, people, wake up. And if this is part of waking people up, the importance of clean water, then we will all be here.
So what's happening with the current administration is they're trying to redefine the map, which is they're redefining what is considered a protected waterway. All of our waterways should be protected, in our opinion, because they all funnel into one another, right?
Today, in the United States, the White House is mounting the biggest assault on the Clean Water Act in history. And while all the national press and the public are fixated kind of on the circus on you know, with Mueller and Roger Stone and Cohen and all this, the Trump administration is attacking all of our clean water rights.
What do you think about barbers and stylists? You know, they consume and use a lot of water on the daily basis with their clientele. What is some things that they can do to get involved with keeping water clean?
I like all the ones everybody else calls.
Barbers and stylists?
Yes.
What can they do? I have no idea what they can do. They can do whatever we do. You know, they can do, it doesn't matter what job you have, they can come out and, you know, help support causes like this and come to these events and help, you know, raise awareness to their clientele that comes in. They want to get a, you know, some kind of styled cut. I don't know. That's the craziest question I've ever had been asked.
There it is, we'll break your records tonight.
What would you say to the stylists and the barbers out there and how they can play an impact on keeping the water clean in their neighborhood?
What a great question, okay? And it's this. At home, when you brush your teeth, we normally leave the water running. Shut it off while you're brushing. It's just like a little simple, turn it back on again. When you're in the salon, okay, or in the barber shop, when you're shampooing hair, put the water on. Obviously, we automatically shut it off when we're not the shampooing hair. Do the same thing at home. I would think the professional beauty industry, whether it's barber or beauty, whatever, do a great job. They turn the water on, shampoo it, turn it off. Turn the water on, rinse it out, turn it off. So they're doing a great job in the salon. Follow the same thing at home.
Well, first of all, your shampoos can be sulfate-free. If you like that, I know a lot of people like your bubbles. A lot of the clients like the bubbles, but if you can tell them, it's still going to be clean. We don't have the lathering bubbles. That's one way. That's one simple thing you can do. But then also, it's really important to make sure your runoff, like even where you, wherever it drains, is into a proper drainage system, so it's not going into a river, a lake, or a stream.
You know, sign every petition. Keep water clean. Do everything you can. Talk to your local government. Talk to your neighborhood. Talk to your neighbors. Teach your kids. It's everything.